warm welcome to all. Today you are going to learn one of the beautiful story, unit 1.5, The Necklace Part 1 by Guy de Maupassant. He is a French writer, widely remembered as a master in storyteller. Maupassant wrote 300 stories, 6 novels, 3 travel books and a volume of verse. This story is about Mathilde, who was a pretty and charming girl. She was born in a clerk family and married to a minor official. She always wanted to lead a luxurious life. One day, her husband brought an invitation card to attend the party at the ministry. So, in this lesson, we are going to see whether she is able to attend the party and what are the things she is arranged to attend the parties, and after attend the party, what are the problems she faced. We will study this chapter in detail. Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl, born as if by an error of fate into a family of clerks. She had no means of becoming known, understood, loved, or be wedded to an aristocrat, and so she let herself be married to a minor official at the Ministry of Education. Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl. Charming means attractive girl. She was a very pretty and attractive girl, born as if by an error of fate. So, unfortunately, she was born in a family of clerk. She had no means of becoming known, understood and loved. Here it is, actually she had no any source to become popular or understood or anyone loved, or to be wedded to an aristocrat, because she wanted to wedded an aristocrat means she wanted to wedded a high social rank person in the society. So, and so she had let herself be married. So, her dream is not succeed. So, due to that, she let herself to be married. She got married with a minor official at the Ministry of Education. Minor official means low level officer of Ministry of Education. She dressed plainly because she had never been able to afford anything better. She suffered endlessly, feeling she was entitled to all the luxuries of life. She suffered because of her shabby, poorly furnished house. All these things that another woman of her class would not even have noticed tormented her and made her resentful. She dreamed of a grand palatial mansion with vast rooms and inviting smaller rooms, perfumed for afternoon chats with close friends. Now, in the second paragraph, she dressed plainly because she had never been able to afford anything better. So, she was simple dress. Plainly dress means she wear simple dress. She had not able to afford. Here, afford means to purchase anything better than this. She suffered endlessly. Endless means no end. She had money problem because she is an average class. But she is admiring more that she should get. Feeling she was entitled to all the luxuries of life. She's thinking that she should get all luxuries and comfort life. She suffered because of her shabby, poorly furnished house. Yes, she was feeling very ashamed of having. Shabby means long use, poorly furnished. Her house furnitures are there. So, she was feeling shame about that. All these things that another woman of her class would not even have noticed. So, she's thinking that nobody should notice her, what she had suffered, that mental suffering, and made her resentful, means unfairly. What she had, she was not satisfied with that, and she was thinking about more upgrade. She dreamed of a grand palatial mansion. She was dreaming a very big palace like house. Mansion means a block of house with vast rooms, so many rooms, and inviting smaller room. And she's telling that she was admiring that she should have a very big palace like house, and in that so many rooms, and in one small room she thought that to invite one of her the close friends in the afternoon time to chat among themselves. It's her thinking level. Yet she had no rich dresses, no jewels, nothing, and these were only few things she loved. She wanted so much to charm, to be envied, to be sought after. In this paragraph, she had no rich dresses and no jewels. Jewels means ornament, and nothing. These were the things like dress, jewels, these, and she wanted to become rich. These were the things she loved. She wanted so much to charm, to be envied, and to be sought after. Means she wanted to be attractive. Charm means here attractive, and to be envied, jealous, to be sought after means looking for. She was all these things she was looking, that everyone should admire her. She had a rich friends, a former schoolmate at the convent, whom she avoided visiting because afterwards she would weep with regret, despair, and misery. And now here, she had a rich friend, a former schoolmate at the convent. Yes, she had met a former school mate, like classmate, you can tell. Convent means hostel schooling, that is school, to whom she avoid visiting. She didn't like to visit, but because afterwards she would weep means a cry with regret. She felt very sad and despair to leave hope and misery, feeling of what we can tell great. Actually, she is a rich friend. Even in front of her, she mentally felt very bad because she is thinking that I am a poor as compared to her. One evening, her husband came home with an air of tramp, holding a large envelope in his hand. "Look," he said, "here's something for you." One evening, her husband, Mathilde's husband, came home with an air of triumph. Triumph means extremely happy, a meaning. And he's having a large envelope in his hand. And look, and he said that, "See, something for you. This one is for you." She tore open the paper and drew out a card which was printed the words. As soon as she was seen the invitations envelope, she tore open the paper, and from that she removed a card. It was printed words. "The Minister of Education and Madam Georges Ramponi request the pleasure of M and Madam Loisel company at the ministry on the evening of Monday, January 18th. The Minister of Education and MME means here stand for already is given, Madam Georges Ramponi.
They have requested pleasure of M. Here it is given Monsieur and Madame Loisel's company at the ministry. They had invitations here. Ministry means government department. On the evening of Monday, January 18th. When there is a program? On 18th January, Monday. Instead of being delighted as her husband had hoped, she threw the invitations on the table resentfully and muttered, "What do you want me to do with that? And what do you expect me to wear if I go?" Instead of being delighted, extremely pleased, her husband, she hoped that she threw an invitation. So why she threw it on the table resentfully or angrily and muttered, means speaking slowly so that other cannot hear. Okay. What do you want me to do with that? Because she's thinking that she don't have any dresses to wear, like that. He hadn't thought of that. He stammered, "Why, the dress you go to the theater in, it seems very nice to me." So now he thought of that. Her husband thought that. He stammered for a quiet moment. He's not speaking. Okay, stammered means here they don't speak well. "Why, the dress you go to the theater in, already she had a dress she wore in the theater, it seems very nice. It's very nice." From Mathilde's husband's side, it is a good dress, not from her. He stopped stunned, distressed to see his wife crying. He stuttered, "What's the matter?" "Let's see, Mathilde, how much would a suitable dress cost?" For a moment, was quite stopped, stunned, means got shocked, distressed, can say upset or worried, by seeing his wife crying. He sluttered, means hesitated. And now he's asking, "What is the matter?" "Let's see, Mathilde, why are you worrying about that? What is the dress cost?" Mathilde's husband asking her. She thought for a moment, computing the cost and also wondering what amount be she could ask for without an immediate refusal. At last she answered hesitantly, "I don't know exactly, but I think I could do it with 400 francs." Now for a moment she thought that, and computing her actual cost of the dress and wondering what is the amount she could ask. Now an immediate refusal. Refusal means to do something. At last she answered. Hesitantly means unsure manner. At last she was demanding. She don't know the dress cost exactly. But now she told an estimate idea about the dress, which cost 400 francs. Francs means money or currency used in France. How much is selling? 400 francs. He turned a little pale because he had been saving that exact amount to buy a gun for a hunting summer in the country near Nandir with a few friends. "However," he said, "very well, I can give you 400 francs, but try to get a really beautiful dress." he turned a little pale. A pale means for a quiet moment he was blank. And now he had been saving the exact amount to buy. Actually, he want to buy a gun for hunting. In where? When? Summer. In which place? Near Nanterre. With his friend. Actually, he want to go for hunting with his friend. So, because of that, he saved certain amount. How many had saved? 400 francs. So, now he is ready to give to Mathilde that amount. And he said that to buy a beautiful dress. The day of the party drew near and Madame Loisel seemed sad, restless, anxious, though her dress was ready. The day of the party drew near. Now, the nearby the days are coming. The party days. When it is the party? Yes, January 18th. It's a Monday. So, it was near the days. Madame Loisel seemed sad, restless, anxious, though her dress was ready. But Madame here, Loisel, even she was sad, restless, anxious. Anxious means no. Though her dress was ready. Her dress was ready, but Loisel is not ready to go to the party. One evening, her husband said to her, "What's the matter? You have been acting strange these last 3 days." Now one evening, Mathilde's husband asked, "What's the matter? You have been acting strange." Strange means surprising. Last 3 days, she replied, "I'm upset that I have no jewels, not a single stone to wear. I would rather not go to the party." Now, first she had a problem of dress, so Mathilde's husband solved. Now, she was upset because she had no jewels. Jewels means ornament. A single stone to wear. I would rather not go to the party. Now, she's telling that I would not go to the party because I don't have the, what, no jewels. "You could wear flowers," he said. "They are very fashionable at this time of year." Now, our husband suggesting that in spite of jewels, you can wear what? Flowers. That also fashionable now in 2 days. Like that, our husband giving an idea. She replied, she was not convinced. The next day, she went to her friend's house and told her of her distress. But she was not convinced, not ready to accept. The next day, she went to her friend's house and she was discussing her problems. Madame Forester went to her mirrored wardrobe, took out a large box, brought it back, opened it and said to Madame Loisel, "Choose, my dear." Now, Mathilde, she is going and discussing with her friends. So, Madame Forrester's friend. So, she, what she did? She was opened her mirror wardrobe, cupboard, large box, and brought it back opened. Said to Madame Loisel, "Choose, my dear." Now, she is giving an option to choose method. Now, she become a, because she got married to Madame Loisel. First Mathilde saw some bracelet, then a parcel necklace. But she saw that some bracelet and then saw a pearl necklace. She tried on the jewelry in the mirror. Now Mathilde, what she was doing? She was trying the what all the ornament Forrester she was shown that she was now trying one by one. She kept asking, "You have nothing else?" Now she was asking, "Do we have anything more than this?" "Why, yes, but I don't know what you like." Now, Madame Forrester, she was telling, "I don't know what you like," to Mathilde. Suddenly she discovered in a black satin box a super diamond necklace, and her heart began to beat with uncontrolled desire. Her hands trembled as she took it. She fastened it around her neck and stood lost in ecstasy as she looked at herself. Suddenly she discovered, means find out, a black satin box. In a black satin box she was find out a super diamond necklace. Now what had happened? By seeing that, her heart felt big and beat. She was so excitement by seeing that. With uncontrolled desire, a strong belief, her hands are trembled. Trembled means shaking. Her hands are started shaking. And she fastened it around her neck. So quickly she was trying that necklace. She stood. She means extreme happiness as she looked at herself. Now she was by trying that necklace, she was very happy. Then she asked, anxious, hesitating, would you lend me this, just this? Now anxiously means joyfully, extreme happy. She was asking, would you lend me this? Would you give this? Why? Yes, of course. Now she was replying, why? Of course, I'll give. She threw her arm round her friend's neck rapturously, then fled with her treasure. She threw her arm around her friend's neck. Now from what happened? She threw her arm around her friend's neck rapturously. It's with very great joy. Okay. Now she was giving. She was ready to give that necklace to Mathilde. The day of the party arrived. Madame Loisel was a success. She was a prettier than all the other women, elegant, gracious, smiling, and full of joy. Now the party, on that party day, Madame Loisel was a success. She was very happy because she was thought that she got dressed and the necklace. She was looking prettier than all the other women on that day in the party. She was elegant, she was very stylish, gracious, kind and pleasant, and with a very smiling face, and she was full of joys. She danced wildly with passion, forgetting everything in the triumph of her beauty and success, floating in a cloud of happiness. Now Lois, she was danced wildly with passion, so much she was excitement, she was very happy now, forgetting she was everything in triumph means success of her beauty. She was very much dancing in the party, cloud of happiness. Extremely she was happy and she was dancing. Mathilde and her husband left at about 4 o'clock in the morning. When they were finally in the street, they could not find a cab. They walked down towards the scene till they found one. They were dropped at their door in the Rue Mathias, and sadly it was all over for her. Now around 4 o'clock become Mathilde and her husband left the party. Now around 4 o'clock in the morning it was, and they will find exactly in the street. They are walking the street, but they are not getting a cab. Cab means taxi. They walked towards a certain place. They were walked till they found one. At last they found one cab. They drop off at their door, and they got in where Rue Mathias means it is a name of the place. It is in France. And sadly it was all over for her, because she quite upset. Why? Because they are walking now after the party. They didn't get a cab for a long, they had a walk. So due to that, quite upset. And they finally get a cab. Now finally, Mathilde and her husband were dropped at their door, in which place? Rue de Matthieu. It's the name of the street in France. Okay. And sadly, it was all over for her. After the enjoyment of the party, she was literally tired. Okay, now she become sad. Now they reached home finally. In front of the mirror, she took a final look at herself in all her glory. But suddenly she uttered a cry. She had no longer had the necklace round her neck. Now, after reaching home, she stood in front of the mirror and at last she had a final look of herself. But suddenly she started crying loudly. She had no longer had the necklace round her neck. Now she had no necklace in her neck. "What the matter?" asked her husband. Now her husband asking, "What is the matter?" She turned towards him, panic stricken. I have no longer Madame Forrester's necklace. Just turning towards her husband, she was panic stricken, means very frightened, and she was shouting like, I no longer have the Forrester's necklace. He stood up distraught. "What? How? That's impossible." Now her husband distraught means worried, and here it's an exclamatory mark. "What? How? These all the exclamatory mark use here. "That's impossible. It is not possible." Let's continue in part 2.